we have to find values of x and y. We have given these two red marks. It means that we have here isosceles triangle. And if these two sides are congruent, it means that these two angles are congruent also. So we have one equation because measure of this angle is y degrees. So it must be equal to this angle, and this angle is given by this expression. So we have 3 times x plus 1 degrees. So we have one equation, and the second, we know that measure of interior angles of triangle is 180 degrees. So we have another equation that y degrees plus 3 times x plus 1 degrees plus 54 degrees is equal 180 degrees. We have two equations, two unknowns. We have that y is equal to this expression. So I will substitute y in the second expression by this whole expression. So we have that 3 x plus 1 degrees plus 3 times x plus 1 degrees plus 54 degrees is equal 180 degrees. So now let's forget about degrees. So we will have 3 times x plus 1 plus 3 times x plus 1, and I will move 54 to the right side. So we have this is equal 180 minus 54. So we have 3 and 3, so it will be 6, because we have the same expression in parentheses, so we can add 3 and 3 will be 6 times x plus 1. So this is equal 180 minus 54 is 126. So now I will divide both sides by 6. So 6 and 6 we can reduce, and we have x plus 1 is equal 21. So I will move 1 to the right side. So we have x is equal 21 minus 1. So x is equal 20. We found x. Now we have to find the y. Let's copy the first equation and let's forget about degrees. So we have that y is equal 3 times x plus 1. So this is equal 3 times x is 20. So we have 20 plus 1. So this is equal 3 times 21 is 63. So we found x and we have y. This is my solution.